Hello, welcome to my channel, Renzo here. Okay, today let's paint a portrait with acrylics. The colors I have here is titanium white, is medium yellow, brilliant red, ultramarine blue, and Mars black. Okay, I'm gonna use synthetic brushes. I have a flat brush, filber brush, this is some kind of angled brush, round. I have a bunch of them. I mean, these are different brands, but if you touch this synthetic hair, it looks like it's the same for all the brushes. Okay, let's paint, let's make a quick sketch. Let's see. I'm gonna use this to spray water. I wanna mix black, red, a touch of yellow, just to draw. Okay, just a second. Okay, let's see, this is the top. Around here. Okay, let's see the limit of my canvas is around here. I can put the face here. I'm just trying to draw the overall shape. Let's see the space. I have space for mixing the colors. Okay, I think I can move the face a little bit to the right. Yeah, that's gonna be better. Okay. Yep. Now let's see how tilted is the face. How tilted is the line for the eyes. I'm gonna use more water. I just want this color to be really transparent. Okay. Now I'm gonna place the eyes, one eye here, one eye here. Brows, eyebrows a little bit up. And always using the regular measurements of any face, from the brow to the nose is the same distance from the nose to the bottom of the chin. Okay, kind of close. You can split the face in three portions, one portion, two portions, and a third one, or 1, 2, 3. Okay. Okay, I think that's okay. Hello, Monique. Oh, yes, Monique, thank you. Hello, Mira. Okay. Let's see. I'm gonna just start painting the lid area on the face. I'm mixing orange here, and I'm going to grade down this orange with a touch of black. Okay, that was too much black. Touch of red and more white. See, more red, more white. At the very beginning, I prefer not to use too much water. I start almost without water and add more water to, let's say, add some thin layers. Okay. Red. Back. Okay. I know, for example, that right now this color looks kind of darker than the light on the picture, but you gotta consider that the light on the picture, I mean, the background is black. There's more contrast on the picture than here on my painting. Hello, Ismar. I use my palette knife. Okay, now I'm gonna use another brush. I'm gonna mix a color for the shadow. But basically, you know, it's the same. Miss orange, a touch of black, more red. And a touch of white. See if this color works. I think it's just too orangey. I'm gonna grade down this color a little bit more. Another brush. This brush is wet. I'm gonna use it just to blend both and create a soft transition between these two values. Now I'm dipping these brushes in wet in water. It's just to keep them wet, while I'm going to use a different brush. Can add more red to the usual reddish areas on the face, the cheeks, the nose, the chin. I'm gonna soften the edge here. Okay. I'm just going to wet this brush again. I don't want the ink to dry on me, because I'm gonna use that again. I'm trying to keep this the first one to make some retouches to go back. Okay. One thing that we have to consider with acrylics is, I don't know if you see, I mean, this color, as soon as it gets dry, it gets a little bit darker. Okay. Now, if I go back after 5-10 minutes with this same brush, same color, if I add on top of this, it's gonna look a little bit lighter, always. Okay, anywhere. Let's add a little bit of blue. Yesterday I got my second vaccine, and I was just so sleepy, so tired, with some fever. I was resting today. I wasn't planning to paint today, but I mean, what else I can do? That's the only thing I do. Even thinking about relaxing, this could be relaxing for me. Okay. Mix some more black. Let's paint background. I'm gonna get a little bit closer here. Okay, just there. Because I'm not so sure right now about the contour of the face. Now let's draw some details. Hello, Marilou. Hello, Thomas. Thomas, you say Vax made me sick for a week. Yeah. I mean, I'm pretty sure I'm not gonna be like a 100% for maybe a couple of more days. Anyway. Okay, let me paint a little bit of this clear. Okay. Okay, now I'm gonna use a lot of water for this. I want this to be transparent. I'm gonna use it to draw. Okay. Lightening the measurements. And if the painting goes wrong, I always can say that it was because of the vaccine. I have excuse today. Okay, stepping back. Let me see. Okay, I need to make this even more transparent. Okay, I'm gonna add more red to this color and more white. I need more white. Let me see, I think this color is better. Yeah. Was it, the previous one was too yellowish. More red, more white. Use a new brush and I'm gonna blend this a little bit. I need a bigger brush. Okay, let's draw again. I mean, when I say draw, I mean to use a really tiny brush and a sketch on top of the what I have here. Yeah. I think the color is better, but the good thing about acrylics is that I can just go over this again and again and again and repeat this so many times. 3, 4, 5. Okay, it's just like the first stage. I can go over the first stage of establishing the values all the times I want. That's what I love about acrylic, just that dry fast. Okay. Monique is saying she was lucky, just soreness in the arm and tired. Yeah. Hello, Nahid. Hello, Barbara. Yeah. Yep. Hello, KDV. Okay, this. Let's add a little bit of details. I see the overall shape of the eye. I'm squinting down my eyes. See shadow here. Okay. I need another brush. Wait 1 minute. I forgot to do this because I mean, you know that I work mostly with oil paints. Sorry, whether you could hear that, that was my cat. One of the cats.
Hello, Majin.
Make everything a little bit darker. Make the background. And okay. Okay. Adding more water, paint, I'm just getting close. I don't want to paint yet a sharp edge here. I'm just getting close, okay? Now everything is a little bit darker. Okay, I need to step back. Okay, I think I'm doing okay. Yeah, I see that maybe the chin is too pointy. I need to work here. I'm squinting down my eyes and I'm just trying to see the distance between the eyes, the nose, and the mouth. Looks like it's okay. the difference between light and shadow. I need to work here. It just is. Let me see. Okay. 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 Just 1 minute. I'm thinking maybe I need to add a layer of some gray color to the skin. I don't know if it's still, I'm pretty sure this is still wet because I added too much paint here, a lot of paint. It's still wet. I'm gonna still working on making details to the nose, the mouth, and then maybe I'm gonna add a glaze to the whole face. Okay, but let's see, I'm not so sure yet about the glaze. About adding a glaze is just thinking about changing the whole color, okay? Make it more maybe orangey, reddish. And like I said, that's an advantage of painting with acrylics, that we can do something that we do with oil paints when the painting is really dry, and usually sometimes when we're about to finish the painting. And here we can do this in any time we want, just to change the color of the painting. Okay, let me see. Okay, hello. Hello, thank you, Thomas. Hello, Laura. Hello, Just Adam. Hello, Mervat. Okay. Hello, Simrat. Thank you. Hello, Tokoa FIFA. Continue working on details. Let's see. I just zoom in the eyes. I'm trying to soften this. I need to paint it again. Now let's paint the nose. Remember, I always change the color for the nose, the mouth, make it more reddish. Okay, let's see. And always check the angles from the middle of the nose. Let's see, is here. Here and the corner of the eye. Okay, check out that angle on top of your picture. And if you have that angle right, pretty sure the length of the nose is gonna be okay. I'm gonna add more light. Let's see. Okay, wait. Okay, I was planning to add one layer of maybe gray, but I'm not gonna be able to do that. I mean, I can feel here this is not still, it's not dry yet, and kind of, you see, kind of sticky. That means I just need to work here, continue working on the lights, and then I'm gonna add some glazes here and there to grade down some areas. Do you also like to paint master copies of portraits? Yeah, I have painted, not a lot, but I have painted like maybe, I don't know, maybe my whole life, like just maybe 10, 12 copies. I mean, just what I see, the surface. I didn't make a really, maybe once I did when I was a student. I don't remember it really clear. It was just a portion of some process, like digging about the canvas that this particular painting used at that time. Yes, and the pigments. Okay. And just going with the first layers, I think I didn't finish the painting. It was a long, I mean, it was really young, it was a longer process, and I didn't do it. I mean, I went to a museum that is close to me, like 10 blocks. I didn't go to that one. Another one that is like maybe 20 minutes from here. And I painted there a copy. I remember it was just one day, like for 4 or 5 hours. I was really happy with the result, but I mean, we learned always something, even when we, let's say, study the process, that is different than when we paint just the surface. We copy the surface, it's different, but I mean, either one way or the other is always a good practice. Yeah. Oh, say like Velázquez or Sargent. Oh, I would love to make a copy of Sargent. Yeah. Hello, Sunflower. Can you do one with Denzel Washington? I did it with oils. Yeah, that's in my YouTube channel. It looked like maybe as 4, 5, 6 months ago. Yeah, I did painting him and I sold the painting. I remember. Thank you, Maisa. Continue. Oh, I was erasing that. Just stepping back. I drain down this color a little bit, okay? I found easier just to start with some, maybe let's say, knockdown color and going up with saturation, then start with a saturated color and knocking down that color. And the problem with, I think maybe with acrylics, is like, that's kind of difficult sometimes to knock down these colors. And it's not just about the material, it's just that we always think that this dries too fast and we try to mix faster. And we mix fast, we don't have time to maybe grain down the color enough. And usually on a portrait painter, painting is usually maybe 60% are just muddy colors. A small portion is where we see some saturated colors, some, like, let's say, vivid. We don't see any vivid color. I mean, we don't see, if we compare a yellow color with any part of the portrait. We do not find it match with red. Yeah? All the colors on the face, even the vivid ones, are going to look mute when you compare them with a really saturated color. I'm keeping this brush wet and not in paint, you see, and with this one I'm blending. I mean, it's not like blending, yeah? You know, this is like fading, because blend is when all the paint is wet. It's kind of a mixture between, let's say, this paint and this paint, both. But right now what I'm doing is just going with this one on top of this one. And just by making it transparent, I create that transition. Okay, this brush is always wet, but it's not like wet, I mean, I dip the brush, you see a lot of water here. Okay, I do this. Then, I do this, and I use it this way. Spraying water on my brushes. Now here, I mean, I don't spray water on the painting because I want the painting dry fast. Okay. Mixing a more saturated orange just for the shadow below the nose. gonna paint the background here. Let's work the contour of the face. Now we need another brush to try to soften that edge. Okay, this brush is wet. This is really difficult to try to make a soft edge with acrylic. Okay, don't try this at home. There's no way to soften that edge. I would like to just to get this really, soften this more in this way. At some point I just can choose what area just to sharpen. I'm gonna leave it there, and I'm gonna just add maybe a grayish color around the face, just to create try to create the illusion of some soft edge. Okay. Don't have too much space here. I want to mix here. Okay, you see this this mixture is kind of gray and with all the colors I have here. That's basically some variation of a dark, like a grayish orangey color. I'm just trying to cool this light, cool down this light. You can see the difference, yeah? It looks really grayish. You see? Okay, first I'm going to gray down this color. And of course, on top of this, I can add a glaze of orange or pink and just bring it back to be colorful or saturated again. I just want to establish first the difference between temperature here, okay? Because this light is different from this light, okay? Now the problem is that I'm not gonna be able to spend like 10 minutes mixing to try to match this exact color here. And what I'm doing is basically adding, let's say, some transparent paint. Okay, because I'm counting on this color here that I'm adding right now to transparent and see both colors, the colors beneath and this color. Okay. And of course, I mean, there's no way to get this color right, perfectly right. It's a process of adding more and more paint. Now I think that area, I can say maybe it's a little bit closer to what I want. Now there's a glow here in this area that you don't see the color right here. But anyway, you see the difference? If I block the light with my hand, maybe you can see the color right. Anyway, let's continue working. I'm gonna add another glaze here. Okay, that's too orangey. I'm gonna make this more grayish. Okay, I'm counting here on a mixture between layers, okay? I'm not mixing here this color with the previous color, and just is just, this is just a glaze. A glaze is a mixture between layers. One transparent layer on top of another layer, okay? Somebody's asking me, what ground do you work on? I'm working on canvas. Let's say that I'm glazing now, and I'm counting that acrylic dry fast. Okay, it's not I don't want this dry slower. I don't use anything, just water. Why is that? Because I want to go back over here in a minute. If I'm trying to go back here and it's wet, I mean, that means more time for me to wait. But this is maybe about things that you were just get used to do. I mean, for me, working with acrylics is just like that. First, start with thick paint. Not thick, but I mean, with not too much water. And then I start adding transparent layers. And adjusting. And that's is the reason that I work with layers. And that's the reason that I want this to dry fast. Okay. Another thing, I mean, I want this to dry fast here, but I want this to go dry slower. I spray my brushes too, because I mean, I don't want my brushes just to dry. Okay. For example, I see some orangey color here, and I'm planning to kill down this by putting this layer here. Okay. Now I double check if maybe it's too grayish, because I added maybe some color that is too dark. I go back there and add a more saturated color. Okay. Paint, step back and compare. I continue to paint. That was about color. Now I gotta think about the likeness again. Okay, I need to compare, I need to work on the left eye. Yeah. Okay, I'm going to go a little bit darker on the eyes. Okay, I'm adding water because I don't want this to be too thick. You know that I go usually, I darken the eyes just little by little, okay? That's easier for me to control and to erase if I make a mistake. Brown. You know that this area we should add more red. Now mixing gray, black and white with the skin color to paint this area of the sclera. Okay, that was too dark. Add more white. Whoa, it was too white. This brush is just wet. I'm using to blend. Work the other eye. My brush had a little bit of white. Wasn't my intention to put the white, that little light there. Okay. Hello, Maisa. I use Thomas K. Carreo saying I use soft acrylics which dry slower. Oh, that's good. Hello, Mary. How are you? Hello, Michael. Okay. Now let's work on the nose. Sorry, the mouth. Let's look at the mouth. Okay, I think that's okay. Let's add some reddish color here, just a little bit. Okay, one thing I don't like right now is just I forget to soften the edge of the neck. I need to paint the background again, and then paint the neck again. And blend and soft this. As soon as it gets dry here, I'm gonna add a glaze on top of this white. Okay, I'll be back in a minute here to work on the pattern. Need to step back and compare. Okay. mixing ultramarine blue and black. Let me see. Okay. Stepping back. Okay. Let me see. Need to make this darker. I think I'm gonna paint everything dark. Okay, this ultramarine blue, to be honest, looks kind of lighter on the screen. It's darker. I'm gonna adjust my camera. It looks like my camera is always trying, every time that I paint something dark, the camera just try to adjust. Okay, I'm gonna use this blue to try to darken. Let's see how much I'm going to darken this. Just thinking about the blue, okay? Yeah, that's the color of the blue. Of course, I don't know if you can see. Do you see any change? But let's see if you see a change. I don't know, you see everything darker now? That's kind of close to the color of this ultramarine blue. Of course, the face is too dark now, but the ultramarine is just the color that I see, close to the color that I see here on my screen. No, I got to put it back. Yeah, it's too dark. Kind of impossible to see, I mean, for you and me to see the same colors here. Anyway, I need to continue working on this. A little bit of white. Yeah, one of these days I'm just going to go and buy a really powerful camera. Yeah, because I mean, it kind of bothers me, the thing about color. Sometimes, I see my own painting, but when I see, when I go to see the comments and I see the screen, I see a different color. Maybe that it does, it have to, maybe it's about the lighting here in my studio. So many things to consider when we're trying to paint, we're trying to film. Pretty good. I'm gonna add red and yellow here. Okay. back for a minute. Check out this. Still see some mistakes here and there. I'm just double checking, I'm stepping back and double checking. Okay, I think I got I'm close to the proportions. Okay, I have problems with this the shadow area. Yeah. Okay, and I need to work a little bit more on colors. And okay, let me think. Okay, maybe the forehead is a little bigger. Okay, this is something that maybe I'm not gonna be able to fix. I took the risk and I painted the here, and if that's wrong, it's gonna be so difficult to fix. That means when it's a darker color, I think it's better just to use a palette knife or even something like this and clean the paint, because you're gonna see, you put a lighter color on top of a darker color, when it gets dry you see some transparency again and again and again and again all the time. Not gonna say, it's just something that happens with acrylic. And consider a good idea just to clean that area out with a palette knife or something. Okay. Okay, let's continue working on the shadow, this area here. I need to mix. I'm mixing, basically remember that what I'm doing with acrylic is exactly what I do with oil paint. It's just a grayish orangey color that I use for the shadows, okay? It's just the same. This brush is wet. Now I'm just using to fade this color on top of the other. I do this and I clean the brush, and I go again. Mix this really dark for this area here. Hello, Gloria. Hello, Laura. When you're gonna try digital art? You know that I bought this mouse pad, and I've been drawing. I've been practicing. I'm getting better, but it's gonna take a while. I mean, it's not fast. I thought that was kind of easy to, but no, it's not. Yep. And right now, in this digital art I'm practicing, all my colors are just too saturated. I mean, it's like I cannot control the color in the digital painting. Yeah. It's like learning again to paint for me. Like, you know, that learning about color is for me, obviously, learning to mix colors and all of that, but it's about harmony between grayish colors, saturated colors. And all my colors in digital portraits I'm practicing are just too saturated. I need to knock them down, and I'm practicing that. Hello, Miriam, how are you? What do you think is easier, oils or acrylic? I mean, right now I think it's easier oils because I'm kind of, I feel like I'm having some problems here. But I mean, it's just, I don't know, I mean, I gotta say that it depends. Yes, I mean, some paintings I found really, let's say, easier to paint with acrylic, some portraits, I don't know. And it was like, oh my god, this is really good. I was thinking about that. Then some paintings is like, I found like some problems. But I gotta say that, I don't know, it's about practice. Everything is about practice, yeah? And practice everything, I mean, any technique. Okay, I think I need to add some highlights to the forehead. Let's see. The color looks really good for me here, but the screen, it just looks so bright. I'm gonna try to adjust it just to see what happens if I change the color a little bit. I'm gonna change the color here. I just want to do this to see what happened on the screen. What happened on the screen when I... Thank you. have a couple of cats here. The problem is they're trying to bite all the cables that I have here. And I have like a lot of cables on the floor. If one of these days I go off, like I mean my camera just turned off and the live stream, that means maybe one of these little cats was successful biting a cable. I cannot close completely the door because I mean I have here, you know, I mean we work with turpentine, linseed oil, the oils, all of that. I mean the smell is not too strong, but if I close everything, definitely I mean I'll start just feeling the smell of the oil paints. These little cats, looks like they're trying to have a baby here. Baby, more baby cats in front of my face. There is no respect here. I add in this lighter color, but it's not as light as the highlights on this fabric. I'm gonna go just little by little, just adding more light. Yeah, I'm not gonna be able to make too many details here. Another thing, what good, great thing about acrylics is, let's say that I misconfused the value here. This is really dark, yeah? But let's say that I misconfused the value and I went light, like I'm doing right now. Okay, I'm gonna be able to go back here as soon as it gets dry and add a glaze of a darker color and just knock down this and make it darker again. Now I'm adding a lighter color. I see some blue here. Let's put this touch of blue. Okay, now I'm gonna add a darker, but darker and reddish color because it looks greenish. Yeah? What I'm doing here is the same that I did here, a darker and then a lighter color on top of that. And I blend. Okay, let me see that. Now this brush is just wet, it doesn't have any paint. looking for a brush. I don't know what happened. I don't have it here. Okay, we'll use another one. I need to add more light here. And this brush is wet. I softened that. That's okay. Yeah, a little bit more red. I need to lay it up here. Okay. Hello, Emmanuel. Oh, yes. Okay. Yes, Miriam. I mean, I'm planning to finish up this maybe in the next 30 minutes. I'm going to start adding more transparent paint and start the scumbling. I mean, add paint with a dry brush. Okay, Blender Pretender. Hello. Krita, an open source digital painting software. I use Photoshop. Okay. Okay, thank you so much, Blender. I'm gonna check out on that. Okay, hello, Nikki. Okay. Are you using Cobalt Blue? No, this is Ultramarine Blue. If you see the color, it looks different in the screen. I know that, I don't know why. I mean, I'm pretty sure it's just a setup on my. This is a not ending story. It's always about the judgment on the camera. I don't know, maybe my camera is just too smart that this camera is trying to judge the light here and the color. I'm using ultramarine blue. And the colors, when I see the colors, titanium white, medium yellow, brilliant red, ultramarine blue and Mars black. The brand is Reefs. Okay, now I'm gonna use more glazes to make some areas darker. For example, this here. I'm gonna use just red and black. That bigger brush, I'm gonna make it really transparent. Okay, that was too much, eh? Let's let it dry anyway. You remember that when acrylics dry, it gets darker a little bit. Okay. No, the last touches, this is not another last touches, but what I usually do at the end, because I mean, we all get tired just to go over again and again, and there are some areas that are kind of difficult to adjust, because every time that I add a little bit of paint, I gotta wait to see if it's dark enough or light enough. And I'm constantly trying to calculate how dark it's gonna dry. It's because about this thing about it, when acrylics is wet, it's lighter. When it's dry, it's darker. And it's not just a little bit. I mean, it's enough to for everybody to see the difference. And that's one of the things that I don't like about acrylics. What I love about acrylics, obviously, is the dry time. They dry faster. I keep saying that because that's especially what I want from acrylics. Because I wanted to add more and more paint. I want to have the possibility to add glazes, to adjust colors, and add more glazes, and add more thick paint and glazes and all of that, yeah? Without thinking that waiting for the painting to dry. That, I mean, I normally do when I paint with oils. I have to stop sometimes and say, okay, I'm gonna fix this next layer, the next stage, maybe a week later when the painting is dry. With acrylic it's different. I can go just, I don't wait anything, I just wait for 5-10 minutes, the painting is dry, and I continue again and again. And that's the amazing thing about acrylics. But I think that's something that we gotta get used to, that, yeah? Because, I mean, when I painted with acrylics, I haven't painted too much with acrylics, but it was maybe when I used these acrylics for the first time, it was maybe 20 years ago, maybe more than 20 years ago. And I gotta tell you that right now, this, any acrylic dry slower without adding anything. At my time, it was faster. For me, I remember it was to mix really fast here, really fast and paint, really fast and paint, because it was constantly drying on me. Right now, you see, I mean, it's just wet, still wet. Sometimes I even forget to do this. Okay, and that's what I have in my head. I mean, that's what I remember. And sometimes when I paint, I'm painting with acrylics and I say, okay, this is dry. No, not yet. I mean, say, what happened? I mean, I want this to dry faster. Yeah, and of course, sometimes I want to dry this to dry slower because I want to blend. Yeah. Well, I take the idea out of my head about blending with acrylics. You know, just think that you're gonna get any softness by adding just more paint on top of paint. More paint and fade one paint on top of the other, one color on top of the other. If you think in that way, I mean, you're gonna be less stressful about this thing that the acrylic is drying and you're not able to blend properly. For example, here, I'm lighting up this area. Okay, now I gotta let it dry because I need to see how dark is that. I know that it's gonna get a little bit darker as soon as it gets dry. The good thing that because it's dry faster, if I see a mistake or the color is not okay, I can just go back in 5 minutes and paint on top of that this again. And fix it. and correct this so many times. Now, if you get used to use acrylics and you try to use oil paint, you're gonna feel the difference. Okay, I have found some people that say, okay, I wanna paint with oils, but I think I'm gonna start with acrylics to get used to the mixture, to get used to this and that, and then I'm gonna just paint with oil paints. I mean, acrylics and oil paints are different things. There is no way to like prepare yourself to paint with oils, painting with acrylics, that's different. You get used to acrylics, when you just gonna paint with oil paint, you see that things are different. You see that oil paint, it doesn't dry, it dries slower. I mean, it doesn't dry at all in 2 hours, 3-4 hours. And you're adding more paint. And the painting is mixing on the canvas more and more. And you're gonna see that maybe it's gonna be a mess on the because you're used to kind of add more paint and kind of every layer kind of covered, but with oil paint sometimes mostly if we move the brush, what's happening, the painting is mixed, and then we start having some problems. I don't think it's if people think in that way anymore, but I have heard that a couple of times, maybe more than a couple of times, people saying, I want to paint with oils, but I'm going to just start painting with acrylics until I get used to mixing colors and all of that. And I got to say, no, wait, I mean, it's not like that. You want to paint with oils, paint with oils. Wanna paint with acrylics, paint with acrylics. Okay, I think this is too dark. And have to narrow and make it up. Okay. Let's see what I'm going to do here. I'm glazing that and making that darker. a mistake. I was painting the pearl here. I don't know what happened with me. It was the vaccine. Okay. Hello, Carol. Hello, David. David Stokko. Hello, Mervat. Thank you. Yeah, Carol, yeah, I'm feeling good now after the second vaccine. Just, of course, I'm feeling myself a little bit slower. Yeah. That means that if usually I put you to sleep watching my video in 20 minutes, today is in 5 minutes. Stepping back, I have to screen down and compare. Now she has this shadow here that I'm doubting about just adding this shadow. Yeah? To be honest, I don't like that shadow there. Another thing that I need to do is where's my brush? Okay, I'm gonna use this brush. Okay, wait for me a minute, I need a new brush. I think here it's in the floor. I was looking for a brush. Okay, I need to open this eye a little bit more. More than open, maybe make this a little bit lighter. Okay, Now I'm not gonna use too much water. Yeah, I'm gonna use something like a scumbling. You know, scumbling is when you use a dry brush. Let's say here's the paint. I do this. I take out the paint, and what is left here with this I paint, and trying to add a little bit of. Okay, I'm gonna zoom in. In this way, you see what I mean. Let's say in this area. Okay, something like this. Just that. If I'm gonna go darker, it's gonna be the same. Darker color, I take up the excess of paint. And okay, I still need to work a little bit on the nostril here. And adding a darker red. And with a wet brush, I blend. Okay. Yeah, for example, I see more light here. I'm gonna use. Okay, I gotta go. But I think, yeah, you see everything here. Okay, for example, this area I see a little bit of, I see this area is a little bit lighter. I'm gonna pick up lighter color, this brush. With this brush, I take out the excess of paint and I do this. Okay, I have too much paint. Even more. Almost no paint there, but enough to make a slight difference. You see, I lighten up this a little bit. Okay, you can use your fingers just to even this layer. Okay, it's not about doing this all over the portrait. It's just to for some retouches. I mean, maybe you go with doing this all over the portrait. It's gonna be okay too. I mostly use this for to do some last retouches when I don't want to paint again on some area. Okay, I need to correct her nose and make it bigger, the wing of the nose. Need to add this shadow here. Okay, where else? There's more shadow here. I mean, this is not dry brush right now. I'm just adding some glazes. Okay, with a glaze I can do this. This shadow. A little bit. I don't like that shadow there. I'm gonna sacrifice that. I need to work here. I think here I need to make the nose a little bit wider. Okay, yeah, maybe a little bit more. Okay, maybe I should reduce here the cheekbone. I think I need to kind of erase this brow. A little bit more. What else? This here. dark. Time to go, I think. My little dog is like a clock. She barks like when she don't see me for more than 2 hours. I'm making grow the iris here. I need to make it grow even more. Okay, I think that's better. Okay, getting to the end. Yeah, that's it, I think. Okay, I'm gonna check out. Stepping back. I'm gonna just use a mirror. Just to see what is wrong. Okay, I think I'm getting pretty close. Yeah. Close enough, I think. Yeah, that's it. I'm pretty sure I can fix some little things, but no more for today, I think. That's it, I think. Okay, what time is it? Okay, it's almost 3 hours. Yeah, I think that's enough. I keep saying that and I'm still here. Okay, that's it for today. I'll read the comments. Maybe a little more highlight in the blue just about the forehead. Okay, thank you, Monique. Yeah. Okay, thank you all. See you next time, okay? You know what? I forgot to put my Buy Me a Coffee link. That would be for tomorrow. Okay. Okay. Thank you so much for being here with me. Take care, you all. And if everything is okay, see you tomorrow. Okay, I'm scrolling up to see if I see a question. Okay. Yep, Nikki, it's really important to squint and step back and compare. Yeah? The idea is compare both the painting and in the picture. Okay, see you all. Thank you so much. What time? Oh, Carol. Oh, tomorrow. Yeah, today. I was just resting. I didn't plan to paint tomorrow. Today, sorry. I thought about just taking 2 days off. Just today and tomorrow. But I started used to feeling better. And I said, okay, I think I'm gonna paint. Let's see. And I'm here. Yeah. Okay. Thank you so much. See you tomorrow. Bye. Tomorrow, I didn't say the time, but maybe at 1 p.m. my time. I think that's 3 p.m. your time, yes, Carol? Yeah, I think. Okay, Monique, you buy my coffee tomorrow. Thank you so much. Okay. Bye-bye, Yuan. As always, I always see something wrong at the end. I'm just gonna open this eye a little bit more. I'm just starting to see some mistakes. I'm gonna be here maybe just a couple of minutes. The upper lip should be a little bit thicker. That's it.